So you have vibrant groups like loyal ladies in the MPP. And the question you keep asking, loyal to what? What are they doing? They are simply cheerleading. The men are taking the decisions. They are the center of decision making at conferences. Where do you find them? You find they are the ones who are doing the serving of the drinks and the foods, and sometimes even in the hotel rooms. That is not the kind of role we expect or we want women to play in our society if we are talking about a fixed nation. A fixed nation is a nation that has parity, is a nation that has inclusivity, is a nation that draws on. You cannot sideline the vast majority of your people. Women constitute about 51% of the entire population. And yet, what percentage do they make in government? What percentage? So proportional representation can address that, where we say that, okay, Gum, of your 1% that you got, 51% or 50% of them must be women. So the party goes into an election. Who wants to become member of parliament? Who wants to speak on behalf of the party in parliament and argue based on our ideology, our vision, our philosophy, and all of that? They vote. It may even have a point where, let's say, a man has clearly won. But to be able to meet that 50% or 51% quota regulation that one needs to be able to, enter parliament, the party will then have to sidestep the man in order to get the woman in. Now look at what that's going to do. Currently, as we speak, the political parties are not investing a kobo in women development or youth development in their parties. They are not taking them to programs or, higher education institutes.
I'm sure they'll disagree with you because they have programs in their parties. All of them have programs. And they are beneficiaries.
And what are they doing? I'm talking about what I'm seeing. And what I'm seeing is that I see women cheerleading. During elections, they get one woman with a big bottles or two of them. They wear the party T-shirt. Their backside is, photographed. And then they splash, vote for MPP. Vote for ND. Is this how we want to treat women in the country? But you see, that's what I'm saying, that even this small change in the electoral system will have an effect on how the political... Currently, what the gender groups are advocating for is, in terms of working on the gender parity, is affirmative action. What they don't understand is that patriarchy is not a man. Patriarchy is a system. So you may have a woman who advances patriarchy. She's the one that assembles young girls and feeds them to these old greedy fools. And then, satisfies their ego and stuff like that.